Okay, I want to set the record straight and defend level one EV chargers because they're super misunderstood and underrated. This video is for those who still think that level one is the ugly duckling in the EV charging family. And today I'll be giving you the top five best things about level one EV chargers. Okay, first things first, what is level one EV charging? Well, it's the simplest way to charge your EV, usually at home. When you buy an EV, most of them will come with a level one charger that you just plug into a standard 120 volt outlet at home, just like your iPhone does. This means that all you need is the charging cable that came with your electric vehicle and you're ready to charge. Okay, but aren't level one EV chargers super slow? Yes, level one chargers are the slowest form of EV charging. But slow is a relative term. Remember that slow turtle? He won the race. That was dumb. Even though it's slow, it still provides enough range for most people. And this is the first point I want to address, and it's range. First, let's talk about how far people usually drive on a daily basis. I did a bit of research on the average distance that people usually drive on a daily basis. And in the United States, let's say to work and back on a standard commute, you're looking at about 50 kilometers or 30 miles. And for Canada, it's surprisingly quite a bit lower, with the average daily commute to work and back being about 10 miles or 15 kilometers, depending on the city. Okay, so now let's talk about how much range you'll get with a level one EV charger. Will it be enough to cover these distances? I always like to use the Tesla Model 3 for my examples because it's the most popular car on the road. And to charge our Model 3, we're plugging our level one charger into a standard 120 volt outlet. We're gonna undershoot it to stay on the safe side and say our outlet is only giving us 1.5 kilowatts of power. And this is each day. So this is more than those averages that we talked about that people drive on a daily basis. I say all this because the main point I want to get across is level one EV charging is usually more than enough for people's daily driving needs. Okay, great. Well, what happens if I go on a long distance road trip? Well, this is where DC fast charging comes in handy, but level one charging can also help out too. And this leads me to my second point about level one EV charging is that it works anywhere. Level one chargers are compatible with any 120 volt outlet that you can find. So this means you can charge your car in anywhere you end up with no special EV charging infrastructure. Think like a friend's house, a hotel, an Airbnb, really anywhere you can find a basic electrical outlet. So even if you find yourself in a strange area with no DC fast chargers, you can still pull out your level one charger and plug in to charge your car in a pinch, as long as you have some extra time on your hands. Okay, number three, let's talk about install at home. And there isn't any. As long as you have an outlet nearby, you're ready to start charging. You don't need to call an electrician to perform an installation or upgrade your electrical service. You already have everything you need. This is great, especially if you rent in an apartment and you don't have the option to install a faster level two charger. You can always just use your level one charger. One thing I'd recommend against though is using multiple extension cords to reach the outlet because this could be a hazard. The fourth best reason is that it's super simple. Along with being convenient at home, it's also very easy. Level one chargers aren't connected to the internet like level two chargers are. So removing all the networking also removes a lot of the headaches that usually come with this. No need to deal with complicated systems or connectors. You just plug in and start charging. It's as simple as using any other electrical appliance. The simplicity makes it perfect for people that are new to driving EVs or just don't want to deal with any problems. You can charge your EV overnight while you're sleeping, just like how you charge your phone. No need to go to a charging station or make a special trip. You just plug in and you're good to go in the morning. The fifth best thing about level one EV charging is that it's super cheap. You're charging with your own electricity, so your electricity bill might go up a bit, but it's really not that much. Where I live, electricity costs about 12 cents per kilowatt. So if you were to plug in and charge your car 8 hours every night, it would cost you less than $1.50 a day to charge your car. So in a month, this is less than $45 in total. And in a year, this is about $500 for the whole year. And this is if you fully deplete your car's battery every day, which most of us won't do. This is a huge plus for budget-conscious drivers, which is realistically all of us. Everyone likes saving money. I know I do. So running some comparisons and calculations, it seems that driving an electric car is about 5 to 10 times cheaper than driving a gas car. If you're wondering who I am or why I care, my name's Trevor and I helped launch 2 successful EV charging startups, and now I make videos on how it works. And I'd love it if you were to subscribe to the channel and keep following the journey. Also, if you had any thoughts, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thanks so much for checking in, and I'll catch you on the next one. Cheers.